People say beauty is pain, and anyone who wants to be beautiful must pay the cost. Our society does a lot of weird things to attain an imagined image of beauty. We deform our hair, our bodies, and our faces in the name of fashion trends. A lot of modern fashion trends can be painful and uncomfortable, such as bikini waxing or plucking the eyebrows. Still, if we look back to the beauty practices of the past, these modern fashion trends seem like child's play by comparison. So, let's jump into today's video, as we have our list of top 10 extreme and deadliest fashion trends in history. Starting the list at number 10, crinoline dresses. By the 1860s, crinolines, also known as panniers or hoop skirts, has reached the height of popularity for women of all social statuses. Invented by R.C. Milliot, the crinoline is among the most dangerous fashion trends in history. It is said that this deadly Victorian fashion garment killed around 3,000 women, and among the most notable victims were William Wilde's illegitimate daughters, Emily and Mary, who died in agony after their swirling crinoline skirts caught fire. It was so hard and took so long for a woman to take off the crinoline that she would often end up being burned alive. Number 9. Lead face paint. Back in the day, women weren't as concerned about the ingredients they put on their faces for beauty purposes. Most products did not even list the ingredients contained in them. In the Victorian era, pale skin was deemed beautiful, so the lead powder was used on faces to allow the user to appear whiter. This fashion trend was considered a symbol of wealth and beauty, while the tanned skin was a symbol of low social class. Actually, Queen Elizabeth I was an avid user of this treatment to get her skin looking youthful and pale. What are some of the side effects? Nothing too serious for a woman, just baldness. Number 8. Needled eyelash extensions. Even in today's world, eyelash extensions remain a popular beauty trend. However, nowadays, it's hardly considered dangerous. This was not always the case. An article published in 1899 suggests that a way for women to make their eyes more attractive was to add eyelashes. The method for doing this was to have them sewn in. A needle was threaded with long hairs taken from one's head and then sewn to the extreme edges of the eyelid between the epidermis and the lower border cartilage of the tragus. This was obviously a dangerous procedure that could often lead to infections that could cause death. But, obviously, in 1800, death did not outweigh chastity and beauty. Number 7. Corset. This one's apparently making a comeback in modern society, with waist trainers being sold on Amazon and other major retailers. But today's wearers, however, can at least enjoy the bodice without suffering the same life-threatening consequences endured by the tightly laced women of the Victorian era. Corsets were an essential undergarment for the Victorian woman. Women who dared not to wear them were considered loose and scandalous. The corset restricted women's breathing, which often led to fainting. Internal organs were also subject to damage, as they were forced to shift from their natural position, which could eventually lead to internal bleeding. Broken ribs, digestive problems, and many more diseases are attributed to corset wearing. Number 6. Nightshade eyes. For everyone who isn't a botanist, nightshade, or belladonna, is a poisonous plant that grows all over the world. This beautiful plant could be crushed up and mixed with water and used as drops in your eyes. Belladonna eye drops would dilate a woman's pupils. The dilated look during the Renaissance era was considered beautiful and seductive. Although many achieved the desired seductive look by administering the toxic eye drops, it was not without sacrifice. This poisonous plant can cause blindness, rapid heartbeat, dry mouth, slurred speech, light sensitivity, inability to urinate, loss of balance, flushed skin, memory loss, confusion, hallucinations, and even death. Number 5. Radioactive hair and makeup. The 1930s, radioactive cosmetics were used by everyone. They were said to fix almost every beauty problem imaginable, from wrinkles to blemishes to dryness. They made a line of beauty products, including perfumes, creams, facial powders, and lipsticks, that contained thorium chloride and radium. Radium was supposed to energize people's skin, but since it is a radioactive substance, it often caused vomiting, anemia, internal bleeding, and eventually cancer. But did you know radium was also used as a way to make the hair appear shinier and smoother? After multiple treatments, hair would glow as radium does. What they didn't know at the time is that radium is highly radioactive, and many women died. Number 4. Stiff high collar. The high and tight collar was popular amongst the 19th century high society. This was a trend for fashionable men. Made from highly starched fabric, it produced the convenience of not changing their shirts every day. But the stiffened material also threatened to cut off the blood supply to the corroded artery in the neck. The obvious outcome of wearing one was death by suffocation. But there were far more direct ways of causing damage. In the early 1800s, there was an apparent case of a man falling and almost beheading himself with his own collar. Number 3. Neck rings. Having a long neck is often seen as a sign of beauty by the Kayan people in Burma. The Kayan women of Myanmar start wearing heavy brass coils around their necks from the age of 5. And as they get older, they add more rings. Wearing the neck rings can be extremely painful, and it can permanently deform the wearer's body. The practice also severely weakens the neck muscles, which worsens as the women get older. Talk about a high price for beauty. Although this is an ancient practice, it is still practiced today. Number 2. Foot binding. Practiced by women in China for over 1,000 years, foot binding became a popular way to display social status. It involves deforming the feet of young girls to permanently fit into a tiny lotus shoe. Although infections could be fatal, most women hoped for infections as they would often lead to the toes falling off. If the woman survived the infection, she would have even tinier feet and would therefore be considered more beautiful and desirable. Despite the discomfort and life-threatening effects, the crippling ritual endured, until finally being officially banned by the New Republic of China in 1912. Number 1. Rib removal. In the name of achieving a slender waist, some women in history have even resorted to having entire ribs removed. No, we're not joking. Rib removal in the Victorian era would have enabled women to achieve a tiny waist, referred to as the wasp waist. This procedure is not well documented. In fact, there is some debate as to the existence of rib removal surgery during the Victorian era. However, some sources state that there were cases of rib removal surgeries in the Victorian era. Still, these often proved to be fatal due to infections. Women in history have gone to great lengths to be more attractive. Nowadays, people see plastic surgery as a drastic, dangerous method people take to get the optimum look. In the past, when plastic surgery wasn't invented, there were far more hazardous ways to get the look you desire. So, which of these fashion trends do you think is the worst? Share it in the comments below. Please give us a like and subscribe to our channel, District 10 TV, for more videos like this. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.